in your view, what are the changes in IES 7 that are most likely to support accounting firms?
Well, let me start off before getting to the changes is maybe just acknowledging. I think there's a clear recognition that in order for firms to achieve their quality objectives, we must have professional accountants that maintain and develop their professional competence throughout their career. So that's the starting point. And a couple of things I think have hit me over my many years in the profession that I think will help drive the maximization of that professional competence. First and foremost to me, I think learning programs that leverage sound instructional design principles and include an assessment as to whether learning objectives have been achieved or not really do maximize the learning experience. Second, I think emphasizing CPD that is relevant to one's role makes a big contribution to the quality of the learning. And then finally, taking learning when it's needed, timely. So if I reflect upon those three components of what I would describe as critical to the quality learning experience, I think the standard does a really good job of promoting the first two. You know, the first one on the emphasis on really using an output-based approach to measuring CPD. It's not enough anymore in today's environment to know how many hours one sat in a classroom to consume CPD. The more important question is, have you maintained or further developed your professional competence? And I think the standard does a really good job of emphasizing that. Regarding relevance, I already made my comments on the CPD framework. And again, I think that's going to continue to drive professional accountants not only consuming and taking CPD, but taking the right CPD. The last critical factor is not in the standard, and that is taking CPD at the right time. And this is where the professional accountant, in all honesty, needs to step up and make sure they are taking the right CPD at the right time. So the standard may not address all of the formula for what I would consider the keys to quality learning, but I think it gets us quite a bit down the road in pointing us in the right direction.
Thank you.